We have this saying, you shouldn't leave an unturned stone. If somebody has an idea, you really should embrace it, because that one, that little spark, can actually change things. So in my opinion, I think it's more not turning the stones, it's more like finding the new stones. My name is Alexander Skau, and I'm an ophthalmologist. So in Norway, most of the people are living in more rural districts where we have long distances between small cities. So to get to a doctor, you probably will need to go by car, by bus, by ferry. And in our part of the region, the Lofoten area, you need normally to take a plane. This is both expensive and time consuming. So normally that will take one day, a full day. And that's only when the weather is good, because if you have a weather issue, you might stay 2 or 3 days. So when they don't have to travel, they could have the same examination within an hour. We have encountered patients that has never been to an eye examination, despite that they have diabetes. And when we saw their pictures, we saw findings that required immediately treatment. And we know that if you do the treatment on the right time and on the right setting, you will preserve your vision. It was quite obvious that we have to rethink the way we are delivering healthcare. And during the last years, we have had a rise of new technology that make this possible. We saw that with the new technology, we could actually do the same without bringing the patients to ourselves at the clinic. We have a cloud-based solution with remote cameras. So the patients are going to a remote place wherever you put the camera. They will have the photography of the retina done, and pictures will then be stored in a secure fashion. And we will be able at the central part of the clinic to look at the pictures and evaluate them. What we are actually doing, we are transporting data and not patients. It has a profound impact on the environmental aspects, because we are saving time both for patients and the travel aspects, reduce the carbon dioxide emissions. I'm very passionate about using the nature, but in a very sensitive way. Being alone in nature, it's not scary. It gives me a good feeling. I'm part of something much bigger than myself. And that feeling is very important for me. We are a part of something bigger. Not just me, but everybody.